Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. In this video, we are going to deal with the nominal phrase, noun phrase. Noun phrase is not sufficient to account for all the data in the English language. For concrete evidence in linguistics, there is the DP hypothesis. For discussing the DP hypothesis, it is a request for all the viewers, if you want to know more about language and linguistics, please subscribe this channel and press the bell icon for our more updates. And let's move now toward our lecture. See, first of all, the examples. Occur. The car of John. John's car. We have these examples. And we have the structure of NP, noun phrase. And we see that our structure will fulfill all the data of all the requirements or not. But the structure of NP only fulfill the data of these three examples. The structure of NP is unable to describe that this example. This is our core point in this video. See, first of all, the previous structure of NP. And what is the previous structure of NP? And see, this is the structure of NP that were developed within our previous videos. And if you don't know what is the structure of lexical categories, you can click over the link and you will know that what the structure of the grammatical categories. And there are five types of grammatical categories: noun, verbs, adverb, adjective, and prepositions. And see the example, occur or the car. And we have the head word noun car, the intermediate projection n bar, and it takes n bar, np takes n bar as a complement. And our structure will be just like this. If we say the car of John, our previous analysis of NP will fulfill these examples too. The car of John. This is the head, and this is projected within the three levels: minimal, intermediate, maximum. This is the three projection. And this NP is taken by the complement by the P of. And this has fulfilled the three projection levels. And this NPP is taken by the complement by the curl N. And this will construct the structure of NP. This is the grammatical structure. But if we have this example, John's car, what will be the solution of this example? This is our core point in this video. And see, what is the structure of NP? Either if we need any additional functional categories over NP or not. Our data tells us that we need a uniform structure for NP and the structure of DP. And see, what is the solution of this phenomenon? These are the two structures of our DPs. And this data tells us that over the NP, we have the functional heads, that is the DP. And this DP also fulfills the endocentricity principle. And what endocentricity principle tells us? It tells us that there must be three projection levels. And our DP hypothesis, our structure of DP fulfill these projection, these three projection levels. And see, if we say that this is the apostrophe S, this is also the head of the DP. And if we say this structure, at this structure we have D is the null head, because in English language and even within the other language we have the null constituent, the null heads. And if we want to draw the structure of this DP, our this structure will be just like this. See the examples. Our DP hypothesis will account for all these examples uniformly. And see, first example, if we take DP as functional head and NP as lexical head, and if DP takes NP as a complement, our data, our structure will fulfill these all, the structure of all these sentences. See the first structure, a or the car. First, car is the head word N, and it fulfills three projection level, and this makes NP, and this NP is taken by complement by the head D, and this becomes the DP after projecting the D bar and DP, and this is our uniform structure. And our this hypothesis, our this structure fulfills the this data. See the second structure, the car of the germ. And we have already discussed that heads can be null. And see, first, here we have the head word germ. And this germ takes the three projection levels, and this becomes the NP. And this NP is taken by the complement by the null head D, because if we place at this level the common noun, it mutates the as a functional head. D, the place, the curl, and this becomes the DP, and this also projects the three levels, and this DP is taken by the complement by the P, and this P projects the three levels, and this P is taken by NP, N as a complement, and our this NP will project at the three levels, and at this we have the NP, and this NP is taken by the complement of the D, and this is our structure, the core of germ. This is our uniform structure. And if we say that John's car, what will be our structure? See that our structure is just like this, and this is the uniform solution for all our problems. And see, the head word is car. It projects N bar and become NP, and this NP takes DP as a complement, the DP, the John, and this is N, and this becomes N bar, and after becoming N bar, it will become NP, and this NP is also taken by complement by the D, and this D projects at the three level, and this becomes the DP, and here we have the functional heads, the apostrophe S, the D heads, and we have these structures, John, God, This is ungrammatical. But what is the solution of this problem? The solution of this problem is that this apostrophe head has possession, has case, and for case marking, it triggers the lower DPs and it takes this DP and its specifiers and this assigns the case, the genitive case, and our structure will be the grammatical structure. And here T reveals that T means that the trace, and I means that index, and this DP moves from this level and takes the at the specified position, and our structure will be the grammatical John's car. And if this DP did not move at this position, our structure will be ungrammatical. And we must follow this principle, this structure. And our new structure in linguistics is the DP hypothesis. This is the uniform solution for all the problem, because if we apply DP the whole nominal phrase, it provides us the solution for all the problem, because it also provides the solution for those NPs that are not dealt by the NP structure. Our DP provides us solution for all the nominal projection, and this DP hypothesis suggests that there is upper structure. And what is the upper structure? There are superimposed the functional categories over the nominal projections. In simple word, we can say that at the NP we have one layer. That one layer is called DP hypothesis, and this DP hypothesis is postulated by Ebony. And if you want to more about language and linguistics, please subscribe this channel and press the bell icon.